Welcome to ChopChopChef! Today I got something different for you. I thought we make a little garden tour of my cascading herbs. Alright? And to do this one, we're going outside. Alright, let's start this one off today. Let's follow me.
Okay, and here we are on my beautiful lavender. Beautiful fresh French lavender. I use this for stocks, for sorbets, ice creams, yeah, and as well sauces. Have a look at that. Just come close. How beautiful it is. And you know what's so nice is? When you have a look around, how many bees are all swirling around, which is a good sign, isn't it? So we're doing good for many things. All right, let's continue the tour. Follow me. And here you can see already my future pineapples, right? Have a look, I mean there's 6 or 7, I have them all spread in my garden. Yeah, they will be of course as well nicely used, you know, for my fruit salad or grilled pineapple and so many, many other things. All right, let's continue in our cascading herb garden. Okay, so now here already, you can see, look how beautiful that is. What we're having here, it's our rosemary, right? So I have so many for beautiful sauces, for lamb, yeah, many, many other things. All right, let's continue. Have a look at this beautiful. This smells so good. And what we have here, there's all different kind of bushes here. Still looks nice and green. Okay, this is obviously nice and green. It's nice and healthy. Now all this one here is ginger. But this still will take a few months to go. And beside this one, if you're focusing here, here will come my fresh planted garlic. So ready as well. Soon more of the leaves getting a little bit more so dried, brownish like this. Then this is ready to be harvested. Okay, we have ginger here and fresh garlic here. Let's come with me. Oh, look at this beautiful herb here. As well, one of my favorite. This one is now a curry herb. It's not a curry leaf. Curry herbs. Yeah, again, of course. For all your chutneys, for all your curries, you know, you name it. When you feel this one, you prickle it up, you smell it, so intense, you know, and you find out where you can use it for. All right, let's continue here. What are we having here? Okay, we're having a little bit of chives. Yeah, here, this needs a little bit freshened up. And then we have beautiful oregano. Yeah, more of this one here. Yeah, beautiful, nice as well. And more rosemary. Okay, my God, my God. And we continue our staircase up here. We have this lovely thyme. Have a look how beautiful, bright and green it looks in this little sunlight what we're having today. It's just fantastic. And what's this one? Yeah. This one is turmeric. You know, the very, very, very well sought after turmeric, yeah, as well, for many things to be used. Yeah, I try this one, I grate it, and I have the turmeric powder. That's what we do. One day I show you that. Okay, turmeric. Well, let's continue. Here we go. And lately, the last 6 months or so, I favor this one here. Now what we're having here is a beautiful Vietnamese coriander. Yeah, for your noodle soups, for your fish stews, and for many, many other things. I always use this as well in my vegetable stock. Very intense, yeah. And you just pick little leaves. You don't chop this one, you just drop this one in your soup. And this goes along with it, with your hot broth, you know, it's just nice. Very nice. And here we go. Here's more of our turmeric. Let's go. Most importantly here, what we found here is our garden keeper. His name is Ed. Here we go, we put him back on so he can do his duties. He's guarding today. He's guarding our beautiful, look at this, basil. So nice, absolute nice. And this, everybody knows this one, is a beautiful mint. I love mint. You know what you do here? You just rip it in your hands. Oh, it's so beautiful. Oh my God, it's so nice. Yeah, mint and basil. Let's continue. We have more turmeric. And now here, we got more, of course, of our ginger and turmeric. And today, I'm not sure if the camera can come along. I try today and harvest just a little bit of the ginger. Well, the ginger will be ready when you see these dry leaves like this. That's definitely a sign that that will be ready. Okay, maybe the camera has to come behind me in my lovely garden. I'm not sure if I can dig something out and just show you what we can harvest. Look at it. I tell you what. Look at it. If you just look at this one, I just put it here in the sun. Isn't that a good sign? We have a nice worm here. So the soil is a good sign for the soil. Yeah. And then our beautiful, freshly harvested ginger. And this one today, I know I have one more thing. We have passion fruits as well. This coming. But look at it. This one, nicely washed up, I just can bite in it. This is beautiful, so intense and fresh. And that's what I do is with my herbs. Here along, we have passion fruits, you know, as well. Beautiful, always nice to have. Anyway, on that note, we finish today our Chop Chop Chef herb garden tour. Till next time, thank you. Okay, just quickly as promised, and here you can see our passion fruits, right? Look at that, they still have a little bit to go, but if the camera focus a little bit more with me here, you know, so you get a better picture of them, perhaps, you know. Have a look here, how beautiful they are. They're all over the place, yeah. Here we go. This one, they will be ripe when they're sort of yellowish color. They need more sunlight, and yes, they need a little bit more water as well. And they grow, and they're beautiful growing along here. This vine, you know, supports them because they're very heavy. Ready to go. Thank you very much. Till next time.